Hello viewers, in the previous lectures we discussed some important problems in the chemical equilibrium topic. Okay, so now in this lecture we are going to discuss some other very important models. Okay, so these are the most repeated type of problems in the different entrance examinations. Every model is very important. Okay, so let us see the first problem. In a reversible reaction, A plus B gives C plus D. Initial concentration of A is twice that of B. Okay, at equilibrium concentration of C is 3 times to the concentration of B. What is the value of Kc? Okay, so first here let us take the given reaction. A plus B gives C plus D. Okay. So in this reaction some information is given that initial concentration of A is twice that of B. Okay, so already we discussed how to write I stable. Okay, so for this one, to write equilibrium constant expression we must know the equilibrium concentration. Yes or no? But here information of initial concentration of reactant is given. So first we should find equilibrium concentration, so then only we can substitute those values in the Kc expression, right? Okay, so initial, so it is given that initial concentration of A is twice that of B. Suppose initial concentration of B is 1 molar, then concentration of A is 2 molar, yes or no? Okay, so whatever the value you take, we get the same result. Okay, suppose if B is 2, A will be 4. If it is 10, it will be 20, whatever it may be. Okay, so initial concentration of A is twice that of B. So this is B is 1 molar, then double to this one is, 2 times to this is concentration of A. Okay, and product is not yet formed. Okay, let us assume that the change is X. Okay, so minus X plus X plus X. Right, 1 molar, 1 mole A, B, 1 mole of C, 1 mole of D. Okay, so that's why here per mole what is the change X? Already we discussed how to find equilibrium concentrations by using I stable in the previous lecture. Okay, clear? Per mole X is the change, so here we have 1 mole, so that's why minus X. Why minus here? Because reactants are converted to product, yes or no? Means some of the reactants are converting to product, so that's why their concentration decreases. And here products are forming, so their concentration increases. So that's why here change is negative, here change is positive. Okay, so at equilibrium, that is 2 minus X, it is 1 minus X, X and X. Okay, so now these are the equilibrium concentrations of A, B, C, D. Okay, now another information is provided here. See, at equilibrium, concentration of C is 3 times to concentration of B. Okay, after reaching equilibrium, concentration of C, how much? X. Okay, concentration of C is equal to the 3 times of concentration of B. So, concentration of C is equal to how much? X. Next, concentration of B equal to how much? 1 minus X into 3. Sir, no, because concentration of C is 3 times to concentration of B. Okay, so from this one, this is given in the problem. So from this condition, you can calculate X equal to 3 minus 3X. If you take 3X, this side we get X plus 3X equal to 3. From this, X plus 3X is 4X. Okay, 4X equal to 3, X equal to 3 by 4. Okay, so what is the change? 3 by 4. Okay, so X equal to 3 by 4. Now, here, next we have to write the Kc expression. Okay, what is the Kc expression for this? How can you write equilibrium concentration? That is the product of concentrations of products by product of the concentrations of the reactants. Sir, this also already we discussed in the previous lecture. So, how to write equilibrium constant expression? Okay. Product of the concentrations of products. So, here C and D are the products by product of the concentrations of the reactants. A and B are the reactants. Now, See, remember that these all are equilibrium concentrations, yes or no? Equilibrium concentrations only we have to take there. So now, what is the equilibrium concentration of Cx? Here we have x equal to 3 by 4. So that is 3 by 4. Same D also into 3 by 4. Okay. So x into x. X value is 3 by 4. So 3 by 4 into 3 by 4 by concentration of A at equilibrium. How much? 2 minus x. That is 2 minus 3 by 4 into. What is the concentration of B at equilibrium? 1 minus x. X equal to how much? 3 by 4. So 1 minus 3 by 4. Okay. So if we simplify this one, Kc is equal to 3 by 4 into 3 by 4 by this. See, 4 is the LCM. 4 into 2, 8 minus 3. 5 by 4 into 4. Again here LCM is 4. 4 into 1, 4. 4 minus 3, that is 1. 1 by 4. Okay, so 4, 4, 4 and 4 will get cancelled. Okay, so finally we have Kc equal to 3 into 3, 9 by 5. Okay, so therefore Kc is equal to 9 by 5 means that is 1.8. Kc is equal to 1.8. Okay, clear? So in this way, this is a very very important model. See here, they didn't provide equilibrium concentration but ask you to find the Kc. To calculate Kc, we must know the equilibrium concentration, yes or no? So for that, by utilizing ice table, first you should find equilibrium concentrations of the both reactants and products. Okay, and then after calculating x, we have substituted in the Kc expression and finally we got Kc equal to 1.8. Okay, now let us see the next problem. A reversible reaction A plus 2B gives 2C plus D is started with 1.1 mole of A and 2.2 mole of B. At equilibrium, number of moles of C equal to 0.2 mole. What is Kc? Okay, see, here also, first let us take this equation, A plus 2B gives 2C plus D. Okay, so same here also, first we should find the equilibrium concentrations, yes or no? Or equilibrium moles, here we have to find. Okay, or equilibrium concentration, because see, in the previous problem they have given concentrations and here they have given moles. Okay, remember that one relation, N is equal to, okay, M into V. Okay, N is equal to M into V. So V is in liter. Okay, so if V is equal to 1, number of moles is equal to molarity. Okay, if volume is 1 liter, then number of moles is equal to molar concentration. Remember that. Okay, so in the previous case, they have directly given molar concentration. And here they have given number of moles. Okay, same procedure, we can find the number of moles at equilibrium by utilizing the ice table. Then we can calculate molar concentrations. Okay, so but here remember that if volume is not mentioned in the problem, means we have to assume that that is a 1 liter container. Okay, nobody tells or mentioned in the examination. If volume of the container is not given, means assume that that is 1 liter container. Okay, so now here initial moles of A is how much? 1.1. Initial moles of B equal to how much? 2.2 mole. Okay, and C and D, they are not yet formed at time t equal to 0. Now let us assume the change is x. So here 1 mole of A is present, so here we get minus x. Here we have 2 mole of B, so that's why here we have minus 2x. Okay, and here 2 moles of C is formed, so that's why 2 C, no, per mole change is x. For 2 moles, 2x. Okay, and here 1 mole of D is formed, so plus x. Next, at equilibrium, 1.1 minus x moles, and this is 2.2 minus 2x moles. It is 2x moles and it is x moles. Okay, so now here, next look at this statement. At equilibrium, number of moles of C equal to 0.2 mole. Okay, at equilibrium, what is the number of moles of C? That equal to 2x. 2x equal to, given that 0.2 mole. Okay, so here you should be very careful. Okay, so from the reaction, if you write I stable, equilibrium moles of C equal to how much? 2x. That is equal to 0.2 mole. Okay, the problem it is given. Right, so now from here we get the x value. X is equal to 0.2 by 2, that equal to 0.1. So x value equal to 0.1 mole. So no, x is equal to 0.1 mole. So now write the Kc expression. Kc is equal to concentration of C whole square into concentration of D by concentration of A into concentration of B whole square. So now this is the Kc expression. Now remember that what are these? These all are moles. Yes or no? Not concentration, but here volume is not mentioned, so that's why this x moles is equal to x molar. Yes or no? Number of moles. Here volume is not given, means we are taking it as 1 liter, so number of moles equal to molar concentration. Okay, so now let us substitute these values. C equal to 2 into 0.1. Okay, so that is equal to 0.2 whole square into D is x, that is equal to 0.1 by. Okay, so here A is 1.1 minus 0.1. Okay, 1.1 minus 0.1 into 2.2 minus 2 into 0.1 whole square. Yes or no? So here 2.2 minus 2x, x is 0.1. Okay, so now here Kc is equal to, see this you can write 2 into 10 power minus 1 whole square into 0.1, we can write 10 power minus 1. Yes or no? For our convenience we are writing. Next here 1.1 minus 0.1 means 1 into 2.2 minus 2 into 0.1. How much? 0.2. 2.2 minus 0.2 equal to 2 whole square. Okay, so now if you simplify this, this we get here is 2 square into 10 power minus 2 into 10 power minus 1 by 2 square. 2 square, 2 square will get cancelled. 10 power minus 2 into 10 power minus 1. So Kc is equal to 10 power minus 3. Okay, Kc is equal to how much? 10 power minus 3. Okay, so here very simple. See, in any problems in which we are going to calculate Kc by finding equilibrium concentrations, just write the I table, find out the equilibrium concentrations. See, they will give some condition like this in the every problem. Yes sir, in the previous case it is given that concentration of C is 3 times to the concentration of B at equilibrium, right? Here given that at equilibrium number of moles of C is 0.2 mole. After finding this one, 2x equal to 0.2. From this we get the change. How many moles is the change? Okay, and then in the Kc expression. Okay, so clear. So now let us see one more problem also. Okay, now let us see another problem. A reversible reaction A plus B gives 2C is started with 2 moles of A and 3 moles of B in a 2 liter container. Okay, and equilibrium constant Kc is 4. What is the concentration of C at equilibrium? Okay, what is the concentration of C at equilibrium? See here, initial moles of reactants are given. and also equilibrium constant is provided. In the previous two models, they didn't provide equilibrium constant. We have calculated equilibrium constant. Okay, so this is a different model. They have provided equilibrium constant and ask you to find the equilibrium concentration of C. Okay, so here also, first let us write I stable, and we should find the equilibrium moles. Okay, moles are given. Yes or no? Okay, remember that here the container is 2 liter container. Okay, so that's why here I stable ICE. Okay, so now initial is how many moles? 2 moles, and for B 3 moles. Okay, and this is 0. Okay, change is how many moles? X 1 mole, so minus X. Here also 1 mole minus X. 2 moles of C is formed, so that's why 2x. Okay, so here it is 2 minus x moles, 3 minus x moles, and 2x moles. Okay, but see here, these all are moles. Yes or no? Not the concentration, molar concentration. Okay, number of moles these are. Okay, so now it is a 2 liter container. Just now we discussed that molar concentration is equal to n by v in liters. Okay, so here, or you can write m. Okay, molar concentration is equal to n by v in liter. Okay, so now here these are the number of moles. So equilibrium concentration of A equal to how much? 2 minus x by 2. Yes or no? These are the number of moles at equilibrium. If you want to get the concentration at equilibrium, means number of moles at equilibrium by volume of the container. How much? 2 liter. Okay. Similarly, concentration of B at equilibrium equal to how much? 3 minus X by 2 volume of the container. And similarly, equilibrium concentration of C is equal to how much? 2X by 2. Okay, 2x by 2. Clear? So now let us take the equilibrium constant expression for this reaction. Kc is equal to concentration of C whole square by concentration of A into concentration of B. So now this is the Kc expression for this one. Now here Kc is already provided. How much? 4. So substitute here. 4 is equal to concentration of C at equilibrium. How much? 2x by 2. Okay, 2x by 2 whole square by concentration of A at equilibrium. How much? 2 minus x by 2. And concentration of B at equilibrium. How much? 3 minus x by 2. Okay. So here 2 power 2 and 2 and 2 will get cancelled. Okay, so finally we have here 4x square. So no, 2x whole square is 4x square by, we have still, we have 2 minus x into 3 minus x. So no, if you simplify that one, 2 into 3, 6. Okay, 2 into minus x, minus 2x, minus x into 3, minus 3x. Okay, minus x into minus x plus x square. Okay, so now if you take this one, this side, we get 4 into, see, 6 minus minus 2x minus 3x equal to minus 5x plus x square is equal to 4x square. Okay, if you simplify this one, we get 4 into 6, that is 24 minus, okay, sorry, see here, no need this one also, you can cancel this 4 and 4, yes or no? Okay, so it will save our time. So 6 minus 5x plus x square equal to x square, x square, x square will get cancelled. So here we have 5x equal to 6, yes or no? If you take this minus 5x to the right side, we get 5x equal to 6, then x is equal to 6 by 5. Okay, x is equal to 6 by 5. Yes or no? See, now we have equilibrium. What is the question here? What is the concentration of C at equilibrium? How much? 2x by 2. Okay, now let us substitute 6x value here. Therefore, concentration of C at equilibrium is equal to 2 into 6 by 5 by 2. Okay, so 2 will get cancelled. So finally here we have equilibrium concentration is equal to 6 by 5. If you simplify this one time, and here we have 1, so that is 0.1.2. Okay, equilibrium concentration of C equal to how much? 1.2. Okay, so clear? So you should be very careful whether the container is 1 liter or other than 1 liter. Okay, clear? So in this way, first write the ice table and then find the equilibrium concentrations. If volume is not given or volume is 1 liter, in that case number of moles equal to molar concentration. Yes, sir, it is 1. Other than 1 liter, then we have to find by utilizing this relation in this way, equilibrium concentration, and then substitute in the Kc expression. Okay, so in the next lecture we discuss some other important models. Okay, thank you.